The Charles Richardson Show is uncensored and is for adults only. Mature or immature, doesn't matter.
Oh yeah, I know all about the FCC.
They will clean up all your talking in a manner such as this.
They will make you take a tinkle when you wanna take a piss.
And they'll make you call fellatio a trouser-friendly kiss.
Here's the plain situation. There's no negotiation with the fellas at the freaking FCC.
They're as stuffy as the stuffiest of special interest groups.
Make a joke about your bowels and they order in the troops.
Any baby with a brain could tell them everybody poops.
Take a tip, take a lesson. You'll never win by messing with the fellas at the freaking FCC.
And if you find yourself with some young sexy thing, you're gonna have to do her with your ding-a-ling.
Cause you can't say penis. So they sent this little warning. They're prepared to do their worst.
And they stuck it in your mailbox, hoping you could be coerced.
I can think of quite another place they should have stuck it first.
They may just be neurotic or possibly psychotic. They're the fellas at the freaking FCC.
Thanks to the Amazon Echo, you can do everything from ordering pizza to streaming music with a simple voice command.
Alexa, play something slow on the country music station.
Okay, here's what I have for extreme constipation. To help relieve constipation...
Unless you have a southern accent.
...step stool while you are sitting on the toilet.
That's why we're introducing Amazon Echo for Southerners. It's packed with the same power and performance as our regular Echo, but built exclusively for Southerners.
Alexa, add biscuits to my grocery list.
Okay, adding flour, baking powder,
no,
sugar.
No, canned biscuits.
Why on earth would you do that? Did somebody steal all your mixing bowls?
Our new Southern Alexa is perfect for every member of the family. Especially the little ones.
A cheetah is.
Tiger is.
A cheetah is.
Tiger is.
Alexa, which one is faster, a cheetah or a tiger?
That's not how you ask a question.
Please tell me which one is faster.
That's more like it. A cheetah can run up to 80 miles per hour, nearly twice as fast as a tiger.
Ha! Told you so.
Excuse me, young lady. Aren't you forgetting something?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Southern Alexa also provides accurate weather updates.
Alexa, what's the weather going to be like today?
Well, my left knee is acting up something awful, so we're probably due for a gully washer.
All right.
Southern Alexa, available in burlap and reclaimed barnwood. Monogramming sold separately.
All you do is stare at the floor. Oh dear penis, I don't like you anymore. It used to be you and me, a paper towel and a dirty magazine. That's all we needed to get by. Now it seems things have changed. I think you're the one to blame, dear penis. I don't like you anymore.
He sings.
Dear Rodney, I don't think I like you anymore. When you get to drinking, you put me places I've never been before. Dear Rodney, I don't like you anymore. Why can't we just get a grip on our man-to-hand relationship? Come to terms of truly how we feel. If we put our heads together, we just stay home forever. Dear penis, I think I like you after all. Oh, interrupt me while you're shaving, shave my balls.
Oh yeah, I know all about the FCC. They
will clean up all your talking in a manner such as this.
They will make you take a tinkle when you wanna take a piss.
And they'll make you call fellatio a trouser-friendly kiss.
Here's the plain situation. There's no negotiation with the fellas at the freaking FCC.
They're as stuffy as the stuffiest of special interest groups.
Make a joke about your bowels and they order in the troops.
Any baby with a brain could tell them everybody poops.
Take a tip, take a lesson. You'll never win by messing with the fellas at the freaking FCC.
And if you find yourself with some young sexy thing, you're gonna have to do her with your ding-a-ling.
Cause you can't say penis. So they sent this little warning. They're prepared to do their worst.
And they stuck it in your mailbox, hoping you could be coerced.
I can think of quite another place they should have stuck it first.
They may just be neurotic or possibly psychotic. They're the fellas at the freaking FCC.
Introducing Trailer Trash Barbie. She's larger and meaner than them other prissy stuck-up thinking they're better than you Barbies. Now, every girl can live the fantasy of ignorance and poverty with her special trailer park friend. Every Trailer Trash Barbie comes complete with 2 packs of Marlboro Lights for Barbie's smoking pleasure, a bottle of drugstore brand scotch to refresh Barbie during her busy day of bitching, stinking, and watching TV. Waffle House and Shoney's uniforms sold separately. Trailer Trash Barbie comes with platinum blonde hair with black roots showing, blue eyeshadow, and cocoa beige colored teeth. Plus, a miracle procreation button. Press button on Barbie's back and she's pregnant again. There's also an action pull spring where Trailer Trash Barbie can say up to 11 phrases, including,
I done told you freaking kids to get the hell out of my yard. Oh, damn constipation again. Where the frig are my cigarettes?
And more. Barbie Double Wide Dream Trailer with stained carpet, broken steps, and black and white TV sold separately. And coming soon, abusive boyfriend Ken with sour milk breath.
I smoke all full of smoke. My wife said I have had enough. That said I'm sick. Get out! So I stumbled down to Kelly's pub across the edge of town. And I told the boys my story and we had another round.
From the Raw Talk Studios in Southwest Florida, it's the Charles Richardson Show.
Hey, what's going on? It is a happy Wednesday. It's hump day, and it's also St. Patrick's Day. Happy green life, everybody. And for those of you who are looking at me and don't see any green on, I am wearing green underwear, and you're just going to take my word for it because I am not showing you that. So no pinching, no pinchy. Actually, the logo on the back of my shirt, which, by the way, the only reason I'm wearing this, I'll tell you in a second, and if you probably take a look at the camera, it is no shame that my color is a little off today, if you know what I mean. The sun took over. But There is actually green on the back of mine, because if you take a look. See
in the back. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I am wearing green today. So it's not like I'm still wearing the green underwear. I'm just doing that just in case. Oh, man. But I am hurting. Oh, my God.
The sun looks good on you, though.
It does?
Well, yeah, it always helps a person's complexion.
Listen, I went from being a white guy to a redneck. I mean, look at this. This is painful.
Well.
It's painful. My God.
You're not supposed to do like a marathon in the sun.
Well, would you call 11 o'clock to 2 o'clock a marathon?
I call it insane.
11 to 2?
Oh, 11 to... No. Well, I thought you meant 2 in the morning.
No. Stop. We're not talking about the wedding. God. And plus, at the same time, 2 in the morning, it is most of that's nighttime anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
So stop it. Anyway, so I know, granted, 11 to 2 is like the
peak hours.
The peak hours of the sun. You're right.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I want to say hi to Tony D. He's on there right now. Karen, not Karen here, but Karen H. And actually, Tony went ahead and tagged in some guy named Jesse. Apparently, there was something going on early in the week about another talk show host, podcaster called Tom Gully. Mm-hmm. And now I've known of him and heard of him and actually have had his show on Raw Talk Online. It was to the point where it's like, you know, he was getting... The only reason I actually reached out to Tom for a show is because him and I simulcasted on the same network, Good Talk Radio,
okay,
when it was still going on. And I think Good Talk's still going on, but it's like, whatever. I don't care anymore. Just like, and again, nothing bad to Jay Parker Radio, but it's like I haven't been able to get on. I send him money because he said he was falling short on paying for the stream and everything like that. So it's like I sent him $20 to kind of help him out. He said he needed 50. I haven't. I think we're pretty much done on Jay Parker Radio, to be honest with you. Whether that still is a thing or not, I don't know. But the only reason why I reached out to Tom Gully is he basically was on Good Talk Radio and actually a major syndicator for Good Talk Radio. And it's like I started listening to the show, and it's like, you know, he has his own group thing going on, kind of like it's kind of like a minor league of the Scotty show, the
oh, okay,
Just for Fun morning show. He doesn't really have anything really to talk about. It's just he goes ahead and talks to people that are communicating with the show, and he's got a decent following, apparently, you know, a lot more than I have on mine.
Nice.
You know, he's got people that continuously goes on. Am I feedbacking on here?
No, I think it's your speaker thing over here.
I got it. So I'm listening to him, and it's like, doesn't really have anything much to say. Apparently, he's got trolls. Apparently, he's got haters, which, bravo to him. Bravo, because honestly, if you don't have trolls, you don't have haters, you really don't have a show. You really don't have anything to look forward to.
Yep.
Like, you know, Scotty.
I actually have one of those on my Facebook.
Yeah.
Yeah, she says she only keeps me, she doesn't block me because she wants to see my life fail.
Oh, my God.
And I'm like, well, how long are you going to keep watching, honey? Because everything on my Facebook's pretty damn good.
Yeah. So, that's true.
Keep watching.
Yeah. You ain't getting, hey, listen, that's why I say keep watching.
Yep.
And even if my life does fail and you get a front row seat, bravo to you.
Mm-hmm.
Bravo to you. You know what? My life may fail. But I will go ahead, pick up the pieces, and I'll continue to post.
And if it makes you feel better about your piece of shit life, then I'm happy to help.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, too. Hey, Tony D's making an early entrance. Let's go ahead and give him the mic. What's up, man?
What's going on, guys? How are you?
Not much. So I was bringing up Tom Gully, which I don't even know we should really...
I'm so glad...
I can curse on here. But hold on a second. So it's the thing. Yeah, because you actually called on Matt Connerton's show, which, by the way, is 4 to 6 Eastern.
Wait. Before you get into it, Matt started this. Matt started all of this 3 days ago.
Well, good. Go ahead.
So what happened was, is that when I was on that bullshit-ass piece of shit station known as Good Talk Radio, the scam. a fucking thief.
Call him out,
Ranger Rob. Ranger Rob, fucking trying to make us pay money and then take money, and then you shut your station down, and then you bring your station back because someone else is taking over it. John Smith's show, you know, another fucking scam artist.
So is he? Now it's been argued that Good Talk is gone. Good Talk is still there. What is it? Is it there? Is it not there? Good Talk's back.
So they unpublished the site.
Whatever.
And then they republished the site, and then I guess someone else took over it, and I guess it was that John Smith bullshit politician, fucking right, you know, MAGA supporter, whatever the fuck he is.
Right.
You know. So anyway,
who the fuck is John Smith? That sounds like a fucking cartoon character on Pocahontas.
Say what you will. Radio is their tag on Facebook.
Yeah, right. Go ahead.
So here's the thing. All right, we're going to have a real good conversation right now about radio. We're going to have a good.
By the way, by the way, how many drinks have you had so far? Come on, St. Patrick's Day.
I'm on my fifth.
All right, cool.
I had three.
Cool. Keep going.
You want me to keep pounding them back?
Well, as long as it makes it interesting, absolutely.
Pound away, Tony. Pound away.
So, Karen, this is how this works, right? So, and like when I was talking to Charles, and like, you know, I'm a big advocate, and even though that I'm hired now through an FM station, I still will say it, that there's a lot of quails when it comes to the people that you deal with. Luckily, the people that I work for are pretty friggin' cool, and they're pretty chill, like with some of the content that I'm going to be delivering. But anyway, the podcast world, you know, was known as internet radio back in the day before it was known as podcasting,
mm-hmm.
right? So no one knew, like, what the fuck you were talking about, internet radio. What do you talk about, HD radio? What do you talk about this and that? And Jesse, P.S., of Jesse's Pod Awful, which I just found out about, is a really good show. It's a single-man show. He goes, like, two and a half hours solo and fucking kills it.
Damn.
Kills it. So what he does is... Jesse will go ahead and find these people that are just like fake. Like they're fake fucking people. Just like how I was when it came to these fake radio stations, these fake people that say that they're gonna promote you and all this shit. And he calls them out live on the air.
Right.
That's what he does. He starts radio wars. That is his job. He puts an end to live streamers is his quote. Is his analogy to his show, and so it's Pod Awful, you know, the end to live streamers. He calls people out. You know, everyone wants to be the Opie and Anthony. Everyone wants to be the Howard Stern, the Kid Chris show. You know, so all these people try to follow in these personas. So anyway, what's today? Wednesday.
Maybe.
Yeah, Wednesday. So it was like Monday. Matt, I called in the Matt show, and Matt was like, "Yo, Tone, do you know, Jesse P.S., you know, Jesse Pod Awful?"
Yep.
And then he asked me about this other guy.
No, that's the guy you tagged in the chat there. Yeah, Jesse Pod Awful.
Yeah. I want him to come in and give you a call also, because listen, he's got some fucking shit on Tom Goley that, like, this guy has literally called colleges on people live on the air and got them expelled from college.
Oh.
Like he has used that kind of content to throw people out of school. Like, he's done it on purpose.
You talking about Tom?
I'm talking about fucking Tom fucking Goley.
All right. Okay. My God, I'm so glad you can fucking cuss on here. I honestly don't know what I would do if I was hired on FM radio. I'd probably celebrate first because, yay, I get to put an FM station on my resume. But it's like, okay, what can't I say? It's going to be basically a longer list than what I can say. Anyway, so, all right, so we're talking about Tom. And like I mentioned before you called in, I had Tom's show on my station, rawtalkonline.com. And the only reason I had it, number one, was to fill time. Number two, because it was part of the Good Talk family. And it's like, you know, I'm trying to show loyalty here, bringing some shows over from another station that does all talk. And it's like, all right. But the problem is, the more and more I keep listening to Tom's show, and this is what I was telling Karen, it's the more and more it's like, he doesn't have anything to say except what other people chime in on his chat, which apparently he has a decent following. Otherwise, he wouldn't have a show, to be honest with you.
Dude, he's got haters. He's got more haters than he's got fans.
Well, yeah,
and like, that's not good. That's not good. That's not good at all.
The problem is the haters are like fans, though. The haters are fans because, sadly to say, if you listen to his show, you're a fan. I don't care if you hate the show, hate him, or both, you're still a fan.
There's just some entities out there that create that base, and they thrive from it.
The thing is, I'm not a hater of Tom. I'm not a liker of Tom. I just don't I don't care for the show, and therefore I just say, pound the pavement there, little man. I don't care.
So this is what happened. This is what happened, right? So Matt took a clip of me ripping into Tom on Monday. Now, Tom had a couple of his fucking gully heads called the Tony D Show, and they got blasted off the air by the boys.
Okay.
We obliterated them. Like, they couldn't even handle the content that we were given.
Last year?
Huh?
What are you talking about? Last year?
This was like May of last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
So May. So this is when you were full balls deep into the show, and Tom decided he wanted to go ahead and crash the party, and you guys said, we're kicking you out of the club.
Yeah, pretty much. So they started calling our show. I had no idea where it was coming from, right? I had no idea who this guy was. I'd never even heard of him. People were talking about he was a CBS broadcaster for sports radio and all this other shit. So I did my research, and I never found a lick.
That monotone son of a bitch was a sportscaster? What was he sportscasting? Golf? Bowling?
Tennis.
Supposedly. So I did my research, and I found nothing on this guy. Nothing. I mean, whether you're in radio or anything, I mean, even back in my, you know, my JRZ days and all that, you could still find something from like 2010 with my name on it.
Yeah.
But there was nothing. There was nothing with this dude's name on it. Like, nothing.
Did he go by another name or something?
So I'm going, who the fuck is Tom Gulley? So the next day, because, you know, we only did the show one day a week.
Yeah.
So the next day, this dude does a show like 6 days a week, right? He does a show like 6 days a week. So I find his show, and I'm listening to it, and I'm going, wow, this is the driest uncircumcised man I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
This dude has probably got the saddest hand job in his entire life from a fucking midget with a fucking nub. That's how bad this guy is. Like, I don't even think this dude could pay to get pussy because of how stupid he is. So I'm listening to this bullshit-ass show, and I put the call out. I say, yo, to the swinging D's, listen, call this dude's show, blast him, take over his show.
Right.
Just take it over. And I put the call out there, and they did. They did the following day.
So that Tony D put out a hit.
It was like a – yeah, I put out a radio hit. So I'm listening on Wednesday. I got Travis from Arizona. I got fucking Mikey from New Hampshire. I got fucking – Glenn from fucking Arizona. I got all these people calling into a show, constantly calling, just boom, blowing his fucking shit up. Destroyed his show. The following day, I called in, and then me and him got into it on the air. He proceeds to tell me that his fans send him giant jars of mayonnaise. Giant jars of mayonnaise, and he shows it on camera. He has
Is that something to be proud
desk.
Of or something? Are you going to be proud of some people giving you giant jars of mayonnaise? What pride is that?
Dude, his fans send him jars of mayonnaise, Charles. I'm not lying to you. Like, they send him
Why? These
massive restaurant industrial
size. All right. What's the point? What's the point of the fucking mayonnaise? Is there a point?
There is no point. It's the fact that his fans send him that. And then they said, you know, when a girl goes to like the gynecologist and they got to put that thing in there and they spread them open to look inside their ovaries and stuff.
Yeah.
That metal tool, whatever the fuck
the
metal tool's called.
Yeah.
He has He has one of them. Why he has one of them is beyond me, but he showed it on the air.
Didn't I hear somebody calling Matt's show claiming that he was a pedophile or something? I heard.
That's what the word is right now is that he is.
Oh,
he's a registered sex offender.
Oh my God.
That should be easy to find.
Yeah, right? I doubt very seriously his name is Tom Gully in real life though. It's got to be something.
Yeah,
it's got to be something else.
That just doesn't sound like a real name.
No, it doesn't.
It just doesn't sound like a real.
Tom, my mind is in the gully because I can't get no funny or whatever.
Gully might be like short for whatever his actual last name.
Gullible
is. So anyway, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I know you're into this because it's a hot topic and everyone's getting into it because it's bringing in listeners and all that shit. So anyway, Matt puts out this video on YouTube on Monday of me talking my shit about Tom Gully, along with trying to get a hold of Jesse. Well, I didn't know Jesse listened to the Matt Connerton show. Me and Jesse got linked up now because of the Matt Connerton show.
Right.
Well, Tom caught wind of me. Now take it, we're like 7 months out from when we had our little radio war. Catches wind of me again.
Okay.
So yesterday he goes ahead and goes on the air without saying my name and starts calling me a Philadelphian scumbag dirtbag show who degrades women and just talks about sex talk. But my numbers
What's so wrong with that?
What's so wrong with that?
Yeah, right.
So what happened was on Good Talk, the tree hugging fucking station, what the real story is that Lone Ranger fucking Lonely Rob cut my show out because I wasn't a fucking Christian show and I wasn't like some Baptist fucking bird hugger and replaced me with Tom Gully. Right, replaced my time slot with Tom Gully and said we would move you to a later slot if we wanted to keep you.
Oh.
And I wasn't playing the debate game because I was already knuckle deep into this guy's ass saying, look, dude, I want to know the stats of what your station's pulling because if we're paying you to be on your fucking Roku,
right,
I want to see numbers in return.
Yeah.
For what we're actually paying for, because I'm not going to pay you money to profit you when nothing's profited me.
Right.
That's not how this works.
No, I get it.
I'm not gonna come to your house and do a shit job on your bathroom and say you want to remodel and then ask for a fucking $5,000 payment when the job is complete shit and you're not happy with it. You know, David would understand that. You would do the best that you would do with that job, so you make sure you got paid.
Right,
right.
So you wanted the money up front before you could show me any proof of statistics on what your station was.
Mm-mm.
Tom was with him. John Smith was with him. So they ganged up against me and said, why aren't you paying? Well, I'm not fucking paying because I'm not you. I'm smart. I want to know what the fuck the station's pulling. I want to see the numbers.
Yep.
Because I'm not going to give you my hard work money for something that I'm not getting in return for maybe one listener who's Rob. You get what I'm saying? The only person who's listening is Rob.
And I'm surprised I'm not getting the evil eye. Well, maybe I am because the monitors are blocking Karen. Not getting the evil eye when I said, listen, $50 a month, which, by the way, I learned later is double than what they are charging you. To be on the Roku, and I said, like, "Can you guys chip in a little bit here and there?" It's like
when I sat there and he negotiated with me, well, tried to negotiate with me, this thing with Roku. I set my own price because I said to him, "I said this is based off of ratings. I said if you're showing me that the numbers are good, I have no problem paying you $50 a month.
Right.
If I'm getting 500 fucking viewers that are viewing this, or 200, 100, whatever, even $50 a dollar a viewer, that's still worth it to me. But when you can't prove to me that you can show the numbers, and then you shut your station down, and then Tom Gully replaces me a guy that talks about zebras smoking cigarettes and jars of mayonnaise, and you replace my show, a good quality show, and then you do this show that's not even a show. It's talking to people in the chat room. That's all you're doing.
Well, it's a good quality show. It's a good quality show to people that think it's a good quality show. But again, if you go ahead, and this is the thing I had with Military Mike, who's trying to take my show national. It's like he has all these stations lined up, military stations, Christian stations. Like, I'm telling Mike, why would you put my station, my show, on a Christian station where I'm swearing up a storm
not
over here? It's not going to work. So, and first off, number one, if you wanted to go ahead and put Tony D's show on your air, or mine, for, you know what? Now I'm getting insulted. Now he thinks that I'm a cleaner show than you? Really? Now I'm insulted. Now it's like you should have kicked me off when you had the chance as well.
Well, listen, you know what he tried to do to you that night. We talked about it.
Yeah, I know.
We talked about it. He was going to pull the plug on you, and he and Karen, friends being friends, me and Charles have become friends, right?
Yep.
I'm not going to let Charles in the blind. The second that this dude sent me a direct message talking about he's going to pull the plug on Charles mid show. What do you think I did? As a friend, I said, "Yo, Charles, you're about to get the plug pulled on you. This dude's talking about pulling the plug on you, and you're paying for this."
Yeah.
No.
You're paying.
I'm paying to be on a station, and he's gonna pull the plug on me. Well, you better give me a fucking refund. And number one, on top of that, Tony, I've been on his station for a while before the Roku was even invented. So where exactly? Either this guy doesn't listen to his own content, or
probably doesn't.
You know what I'm saying? And like you had mentioned, he hardly ever promotes anything. So it's like, it's whatever. It is what it is. You know, if he doesn't want to promote his own shows and his own content, what am I doing this for? What am I doing? Why do you have me on here just to fill airspace? Is that it?
That's it. That's it. It's completely to fill a spot. It's not about you.
So if that's
the
case,
worker.
If that's the case, if you're just looking to fill airtime, what does it matter what the fuck I say on my show, or for that matter,
right.
What you say on your show?
True.
It's a click. It's a click thing.
Yeah.
See, he's been with these people like the Tom Goley show, the John Smith show, the Say What You Will Sports, and all this other bullshit. Mm. They've been involved in this clique for years, right? They kind of evolved into this thing together, and then they were like, oh, well, we got these time slots available, so let's start like us four are going to dictate who can do what on this show. We just got to fill slots in, but no matter what, we have the final say.
Doesn't that sound like a corporation? Or, not dictatorship, but doesn't that sound like, people, program directors getting together, finding out what they want on their station?
Absolutely.
That's all it is.
Absolutely.
You can't really blame them for that.
The Morning Mayhem does it right.
Yeah.
The Morning Mayhem does it right.
Which is why they're on my station.
He did it right. There is no middleman. There is no talking about money and fucking shit. It's talking about a good quality show.
Yep.
It's a good quality piece of material that you're putting out there. It's not ass. It's entertaining, and it's always entertaining, and every day it's something different. Where you have the Tom fucking Goley show, where it's the same shit every day, 15-minute clickbaits that he gets 10 minutes prior to his show going on the air, and that's what he talks about. But then he likes to go ahead and then take digs at me, then take digs at Jesse, then take digs at other shows because they're not up to his standards. Like, he's the fucking god of fucking radio. Well, I hate to break it to you. You're not on the fucking radio.
Right.
You're on the internet. There's a difference. You're not on the radio.
I like where on Matt's show, I think it was Tuesday or Monday, I like it how this one guy busting Matt's balls because, you haven't addressed the station identification in over an hour. The fuck cares? He's still on FM radio. He's still on the internet. He's still doing a show. And who the fuck cares if I don't announce the stations I'm on? You're listening to me, aren't you? What the fuck do you care what stations I'm on? Just saying.
Yeah, you don't. Like, go ahead.
No, I'm just saying, these people, it's like they're digging Matt a freaking grave. And Matt, I felt bad for Matt because regardless if he started it or not, he was over here, I think, feeling deeply offended that he was losing some of his so-called friends or so-called listeners. And that's
the local,
why I called
the
in.
The local community.
Yeah, and that's why I called in. It's like, see, listen.
The local community started saying, whoa, this is too much for us. This is way over the line. This isn't like, you know, sit down, have a cup of coffee or a cup of tea and listen to this radio show. You're listening to a legit fucking hit radio show that's going hit for hit for hit for hit for hit. I'm going to tell you something. Drama sells in radio. That is the number one seller in radio, is drama.
Yep.
Because if you don't have it, your show sucks. That's just it. If whether it's a dispute between you and the guys on the show, or a dispute with you and the callers, or you and the listeners, if you don't have it, your show sucks. That's it. It's like having dry eyes. It's just going to constantly just fucking burn until you get that thing fucking wet. That is it. This is the shit that I'm talking about. So when you have these other stations, so let me revert back to just what happened. So he started this video. I have Tom Goley took a real big shot at me yesterday because I'm going back on FM. Thinks that I'm censored now. Thinks that I can't say anything because he can go to the station and get me fired for whatever that my response might be to whatever he says. And he's right. He does got me by the balls right now because I do have to watch what I have to say, because in 2 weeks,
now don't forget, this could be streaming. Don't forget that this whole show right here, even though you're able to curse on that, for whatever he may be able to go to this show and say, hey, you hear what this guy was talking about me? And he's dropped the F-bomb here and there, even though it's legitimate and it's okay here. Just saying. I mean, how good
are
you guys?
I still have my rights of freedom. Look, this is where the suit thing comes in with me, where me and you were talking before. I still have my freedom of speech. So I'm not.
As long as it's not done on. As long as it's not done on the wolf.
Yeah, if I'm not clocked in, guess what? I'm calling your show and we're talking some shit.
Okay.
That's the way it works.
All right.
Because at the end of the day, I still got my freedom of speech, and that's it. If I get fired, I get fired. I don't give a fuck. I mean, I still got my day job. I don't care. But, you know, ultimately, so he puts out this video. Tom Goley takes a shot at me. Tom thinks now that I'm not going to respond back to him because of the fact that I'm on FM. Thinks he has me by the balls. Well, Tom is wrong. Mm-hmm. Tom is very wrong. Because in the next hour, once I put my kid to bed, I'm going behind the mic for about an hour, and I'm going to do a whole fucking show, a Tony D show, with myself about Tom Goley and about how he's a fake radio show host, how he uses his platform to de-platform people. You know, he's done that too. He did that to Jesse. He de-platformed his whole entire YouTube channel. He did that. So
I actually looked him up. He's still there. I mean, what did he
on YouTube?
Yeah,
on YouTube.
Oh, on YouTube. Oh no. I went. I did the podawful.com.
No.
Okay.
No. They demonetized him on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
They took all his his whole channel down. So what my advice to you is, stay the fuck away. Like that Jay Parker radio, get the fuck off there. Get the fuck off there. It's not even worth it. That guy's hit me up so many times and he's never come through with anything. Like it's just like,
well, and
I don't even know. He's asked me for money. He's asked me for money.
It's getting sad because it's like, you know, I asked him, hey, is the station still going? And I actually went ahead and told him, because he was on, not Anchor, but this other Airbnb thing. Whatever. Yeah, I think so. Whatever. But I said, listen, dude, go to Radio Jar. This thing is cheap. It gives you unlimited listeners, unlimited audio. You can go ahead and do, $30, $40 a month. I mean, can you swing that? Yeah, sounds good. And he did it. He went ahead and switched over. Now he can't afford it anymore. It's like, Well, listen, if you can't afford it anymore, then just turn it down.
This is so easy to do, Charles. This is so easy to do. Anyone can do this. See, you did it right. You got a nice website. You got the player up there. You got your music that plays. You have your shows. We just got to build the audience. Just got to build the audience so people can get there.
I know.
That's the ultimate. There's nothing else that's wrong with it. There's nothing else that's wrong with it. The only thing is it's like, how do I build the audience? That's everyone's question. Yep. How do you build the audience to get to where you need to be?
That's the $1 million question. Because if you know the answer, you're raking in $1 million.
Yeah, I wish I had an answer for you.
Yeah.
Look, I built something and I just let it go. I just let it go because I'm moving on to I want to say greater things, but it seems like I'm getting pulled back in to this internet world where I'm going to have to respond to this jerk off now and have to let this guy, you know, really get the Tony date.
But Tony, let me ask you a question though. Is it really worth going ahead? What's the response going to do for you? Like, is it just for in the back of your mind saying, I don't want to be a pussy and I'm just going to go ahead and, you know, guns blazing at Tom? What is it really going to do for you? I mean,
so what it's going to do for me is that I leave no stone unturned. That's my motto for my entire life.
Okay.
I will do what I have to do. But when you take a personal shot at me, and then when you want to bring family shit into it, or you want to dig into like my wife being pregnant, and that's the reason why that I got off the air and all this other shit, I have to respond. I have to respond, because if I don't respond, it allows you to go ahead and get another one up on top of me, and then another one on top of me, and then people start wondering, why aren't you saying anything? Oh, is he being censored? Look, he turned into this glorified pussy because now he's on FM radio. He can't say no.
So you worried about people thinking about you being a pussy? Is basically your Tom Gully's bitch?
Not being a pussy, but being silenced. Being silenced. That all of a sudden, because I took a job on FM, all of a sudden he's silent now. The Tony D that everyone knows is going to be silent to this radio war
But the thing is, the people that listen to your show, do you really think they listen to Tom's show? And even if that is the case, do you really think they give a shit about what Tom says?
No.
That's what I'm saying.
Obviously, there's a huge difference there between shows.
Yeah.
And obviously hosts too. There's a big difference between hosts. I mean, just what we've been doing here for the last 20 minutes is entertaining enough, more than Tom's last fucking four shows. But ultimately, I have to, whether it's one thing that I say, or it's a 20-minute thing that I say, it has to be short, sweet, simple, to the point that it's like, hey, listen, you're trying your ass off to be this type of show, but you're not getting to that point because all you do is you talk to two people during the show. You talk your chat. And like Jesse, like with Jesse, like he's attacked his show.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you know, he's in it to smash you. He's in it to bash you. He's not in it for news, politics, sex, drugs, rock and roll. He's in it to bash you for being fake. So if in reality, that's what Tom is trying to say to me, is that I'm some fake dude who is going to be silenced now and isn't going to be the same guy. As long as I do one thing by posting like one video or one audio clip and I just put it there, lay it to rest, put the dirt on top of it and move on, I have to respond.
Well,
and
if you want if you want to take my two cents into consideration, by all means. But if not, I hear you. You're your own beast, man. But make it simple and quick. Don't drag it out for an hour. Make it like a quick 10-minute statement. Make it like an Eminem song for 5 minutes, and just go in, go out, and that's it. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I plan on doing. But what I also do plan on doing, though, also in this video, is calling out those bullshit stations that I was a part of that are trying to scam people for money.
Well, yeah, I mean, you can do that.
Because if I'm going to let the cat out the bag, I might as well let the whole fucking bag out.
Dude, you better. You know what I mean? If you're going to do this before 9 p.m., man, you get me in on it. Because I'll go ahead. I got a few freaking stations of my own that I would like to go ahead and point out. And Jay Parker, yeah, I think, is one of them.
Yeah, because, listen, it's a scam. I don't know if Jay Parker ever hit you up and asked you for money.
No. I've always offered. I felt bad for the guy. But that was my own ignorance.
He would hit me up and say, well, I need like $30 to keep this running a month. Is there any way that you can help me? It's like, yo, fuck you, dude. Like, I ain't giving you no fucking money. Like, this is your thing. Like if you were a successful station and, like, again, I have no problem giving money to successful radio stations to be a part of your platform. No problem whatsoever. But have the audience.
Right.
Have the audience. Don't start something. And Karen, and this is what they do. They'll start a station, say like 2 weeks prior to today, right?
Okay.
And then they'll start going around the people's shows and saying, hey, I got this platform. You will be a syndicated show. Okay. Let me know a little bit more. Where are you being syndicated to? Well, we're syndicated across the globe. We're our strong points are in the eastern side of the United States. Okay, can I see the statistics? All of a sudden, you never hear back. Mm-hmm. It's when you go in with facts and the smarts of, well, send me over some statistics to show me what you're doing, and then we'll make a decision. They never come back with the facts. And that's been like 80% of them. It's been about 80%.
Yeah. I mean, I'll go ahead and give you numbers too. I'll go ahead and give you numbers, but the problem is numbers ain't that great. If I'll give you numbers.
Yeah. but to me and you are friends.
Yeah, I hear.
So like there's a difference, right? There's a difference. Like, I'm not going to call it a click. I'm going to call it a friendship. We obviously did stuff for you to help build your site to what it was.
Yep.
And we did that free of charge because you're a friend. Did that because we like you and because you're a good guy. But like, when you come out of the blue and you message me or you out of the blue and say, hey, we want to put you on here, and you're this so-called established radio station, but you have no listeners, but you're demanding money, whether it's $5, $10, $20.
Right.
$5 is still me giving you money to something that's not benefiting me any way, shape, or form. You want to know how I got successful? Fucking podcasting, dude. Putting it on for download. That's how I got known. I uploaded it to every damn platform that was out there, and that's how I got known. I didn't do anything with live stuff. Actually, live stuff didn't come into play till about June. About June is when I met you.
Yeah, because that's what I was saying. Let's take this shit live.
So June is when we began going live, and we were multitasking, still getting our downloads.
Mm-hmm.
And still getting views from the live. But we also started losing downloads because people were then tuning into the live because they like to be able to call in. These people that do this shit, they do it wrong. They do it wrong. They demand. They don't try to negotiate. They demand money. They demand that your shit be in by this time because they're program team, like Rob said, that was the best. That was the fucking best when he told me that. He had a program team of six people that needed to program in before 9 p.m. each night so they could program it into the station. When all I knew was when I sent it over to him, it was him opening up his email to download the file because it showed you that he downloaded the file.
Yep.
There was no program team. There was no program team. So you, I'm gonna be honest with you. You got one over on me. He bullshitted me so well, and I can usually see through bullshit. He bullshitted me so well that he's been doing this for so long that I was even blind to it because I legitimately thought that this dude had this whole PR team, had this whole program directing team, this street team. He got one over on me. And then when I went and I looked at all of his followers, they were all people from like Bangladesh and Pakistan that followed his show. They weren't legitimate people. They weren't legitimate people. So that tells me he was selling his show or his station to international waters and groups overseas, probably prompting like a $50 gift card. And that's why people started liking his page.
Yeah. Hey, what are you going to do?
See, my mind goes and I go, you know what? I see through the bullshit, but he got one over on me.
Yeah.
Made me look like a real fucking idiot.
Well,
so,
come on.
Anyway,
real fucking idiot for what? Six people? So.
But I don't want to take up too much more of your time. I just wanted to call in because it's a hot topic.
Yeah, it seems like it. And I hope Jesse gets back on his feet, at least. I guess he's not protesting, but trying to get back on YouTube, I guess. So I hope everything goes well for him.
Yeah, he's fighting. Don't be surprised if his fans and stuff, I'm going to try to gear them over to here and get them in the chat. And then maybe Jesse will even call in because he's a good dude. Smart kid.
Nice. So. Yeah, we'll welcome him. Absolutely. All right, man, Tony. So. Stay strong. Keep swinging.
You stay swinging too, my friend.
Thank you. Bye-bye. All right. Okay. Tony D, soon to be on an FM up there in Jersey. No longer with the Tony D show, but he says he's going live. He's going to out some people tonight. So we'll see what happens. We'll go ahead and take a break. We're almost to the top of the hour. And we'll welcome your calls, of course, 813-699-5353. Tune back. We'll see you on the flip side. Just don't go anywhere.
Off to grab a beer. We'll be right back after this.
Against the wall, I see.
dead. The lies I've told better left unsaid. This can't be it. Cycle goes, it never ends. Your words echo inside my head. They capture me.
From the one and only Cat McSnatch coming at ya.
Don't be a racist, don't be a fool. Everyone is different, everyone is cool.
Everyone is
don't generalize, don't believe the lies. Racism is hatred in disguise.
Alright, we're gonna wind it up here now, people, let's into it.
Just because you're Asian does not mean you are smart. Just because you're Brazilian don't mean you are a slut. Just because you're Jewish doesn't mean you're tight. Because you're rich and fat does not mean you are white.
Why?
Don't be a dick. Because I know I'm a hypocrite. Racism is wrong. Unless you put it into a song. Just because you're Swedish does not mean you are fun. Just because you're American don't mean you own a gun. Just because you're Italian don't mean you can cook. Just because your skin is black don't mean you are a crook.
Now you're not a crook because of the color of your skin. Yeah.
Don't be a dick. Just because you're French don't mean that you eat snakes. But if you're Japanese, stop muttering the way. Don't be a dick. Cause I know I'm a hypocrite. Racism is wrong. Unless you put it into a song.
Alright, we're gonna do it one more time for the people.
Don't get fuzzy. Call Charles now. 813-699-5353.
Amazing how you flirt. Flash that skirt.
All All right, everybody, welcome back to the show. 813-699-5353. Let me get the camera back on here. We have everything fixed now. We got two ladies and a dude in the studio right now. Karen on the top, Alyssa on the bottom, positions they like. Yep. That's what I'm saying, yeah. Right there on the bottom. Tony D calling us up, ousting another talk show host and...
Very same time. Well, we got news today.
Now, listen to how boring this show is.
We got a little news for you.
Good little news.
A little bit of news, just a little bit.
How many times is he going to say that?
The first story.
There I don't know.
Is.
Maybe another time.
All right.
Let's hit, listen to this.
Stupid iPad.
Look at all this dead air. Oh, iPad.
Let's see
Ooh.
What we got here for a clip.
Well, that's the first problem right there. He's using an iPad.
Right. Now he's playing movie clips.
Oh, are invisible?
Apparently somebody got a little touch-up recently. Got a little touch-up is all.
I'm so entertained right now.
I don't know
what to do.
Yeah, there we go.
Better ready to go ahead and rip a new one.
He's got a little touch-up is what happened to
touch-up,
him.
Apparently. Touch-up. We get it, Tom. You said touch-up.
All righty. Southern California woman has been found dead after she vanished on a solo hike. Narina Avakian was discovered near the Mount Waterman Trail in the Angeles National Forest in San Fernando around 1:30 p.m. Saturday, Glendale police said. Avakian was last seen when she set out March 7th from her home in Glendale for a one-day hiking expedition. But when she didn't return the following day, her family reported her missing to authorities. Avakian didn't cause of death, killer, pockets. This is where he is, Parker, a law enforcement officer and two counts of. And he paid.
See, I don't. When I go ahead and read a story, I usually paraphrase. I don't go into the whole goddamn freaking story.
Word for word.
I don't usually paraphrase because I'm not very good at it.
Well, that's just for the good news.
He said, oh my God, make it stop.
Yeah.
Giant mansions and two castles in Europe. His own island in the Bahamas. He says, I was just about to say I knew someone with a trunk in it. Dolores Colbert says, Reynolds declared in rug of uncopla like. So
this was Monday's show. I'm trying to see if I can get any dirt on what happened.
There's three. Francis was so broke by 2015. He spoke
he was in a really monotone voice and put everybody to sleep. And by the time he got to whatever point he got to, nobody was listening.
And it was Tuesday.
Just want to let you know that tonight's time is 8:05 p.m. I hope you went ahead and put your clocks ahead for the spring forward edition of the time zone that you live in. And if you didn't, this is probably the best time for you to do that. So I will hold while you put your clock ahead.
You know,
I'll still hold.
I was putting stuff in him bed while I was getting him in his pajamas, and he goes, Mommy, it's morning.
Yeah.
I said, no, it's not morning, it's night. But it's not dark out, Mommy. Mm-hmm. It's morning.
My kids used to tell Tom by wake-ups. How many wake-ups until the birthday party? How many wake-ups? I'm like, it's days. How many days? I know. How many wake-ups?
Now, I am still waiting for you to
I've heard kids calculate it by sleeps.
Excuse me. I'm still waiting for the rest of the audience to turn their clocks ahead so it reads 8:06 p.m. Eastern time.
You may need to read
maybe
my
sections.
Clock. Reads 8:06 p.m.
Now, for you not living in Eastern time zone, it is okay. Central time zone, I will go ahead and read off the time zones in precise order. In Central time zone, it is 7:06 p.m. at this time. In Mountain time zone, it is 6:06 p.m. In Pacific time zone, it is 5:06 p.m. So you know exactly the time that you pulled the trigger to shoot yourself in the head.
It's just beer 30.
It's beer 30, yeah.
What's this here? Oh, most expensive domain names ever.
Now that's exciting.
Who cares?
Let's find out what the most expensive donate.
Let's see what happens.
It sounds
live
like
with
he's
Lamar.
Just like
Lamar.
Scrolling through Facebook. Oh, what's this here? Oh, most expensive domain names. Mm. Well, let's look at that. What's that all about?
Oh wow. Winds are reported to be at 70 miles an hour tonight with projected tornado warnings. This is from Michael Paul Gross there in Georgia. So I hope you live in Georgia. Otherwise, you could give two shits. Here is Tuvalu. Tuvalu, yeah, the microwave thing here. Here is Enlightened, one gram of net carbs, mint chocolate chunk ice cream somebody posted. I'm glad they're enjoying that. Oh, and
it
here
gives
is
me heartburn.
Does it?
Yeah, I got pregnant with mint chocolate chip ice cream.
Oh,
I got pregnant with the twins, and my sister-in-law was like, "Oh, you're pregnant now, so you have to have mint chocolate chip ice cream." Never heard that in my life before.
What does that have to do with?
That's
being
what
pregnant?
I have no idea. So she's like,
"I thought it was pickles and ice cream." Me too.
She's stupid. She hated me anyway. So she feeds me this mint chocolate chip ice cream. I swear to you, I was burping it at their delivery. It was disgusting. It never left. I have not been able to eat it since.
Is going I love mint ice to cream. Get.
All right. I'm really. I'm really done listening to this. Why are we still listening to this?
Hold on.
We all know what happened there. I don't think we need to go any further into Michael Vick. I have some other stories here.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait. He has other stories. Hold on a second.
Decide to get to them.
It's 5 seconds.
I don't think we need to get into Michael Vick, do we?
No.
No.
What's this here?
Oh, because people see what your screen is.
Most expensive domain names ever. We'll do that.
I'm telling you, he's just scrolling through.
So we could put our kids with any social media account in front of a microphone and be more entertaining than
this
guy.
No, you know what it is? This is the stuff that kids will fall asleep to. So ooh. if you're having problems getting
Stephen
your kids
would have
to
moved on to 15 different subjects all at once.
Yeah. I mean, literally.
Did you see that bird fly by? Oh, look, the sky is blue. There's a green frog over there. There's a,
that
there's
is
a dog
more entertaining
barking
than this
running
guy.
Down the street.
Right? Oh, my God. We were doing the Coca-Cola bottle blasters. He was lit up as soon
his
as I put
giggle.
Those Mentos in there. Volcano. Ah!
His giggle is so contagious. I can't help but laugh when he laughs.
I mean, it's so contagious. You either want to listen to giggles or you want to listen to this.
No,
see what
that's
happens live with Lamar. Lamar is going.
Somebody needs to shoot the Coca-Cola up his ass.
So you did the Coca-Cola.
Yeah,
Mentos
we did two bottles.
Yes.
See, here's the thing too. It's kind of a waste because it's like you buy the big bottles of Coke. I mean, that thing shoots up. I mean, that thing's a cum shot waiting to happen on a porn, I'm telling you. So you go ahead and you put the Mentos in, and literally it's not long after, it finishes. I mean, that thing is in serious need of some ED medication to go ahead and kind of like, hey, listen, you got to
tone it down.
Yeah,
it doesn't last long.
No, it doesn't.
But I'm sure he had fun with it.
No, erection would last long listening to this either.
He is going to decapitate that poor kid.
What? Oh, my God.
He just is. Yeah, Lenny Dykstra.
Why are we still listening to this? I don't know. I was on a mission to try to find some dirt on Monday's show.
I thought it's St. Patty's Day. We're supposed to be hyping
up.
It
was calm and purring.
By the way, Charles, I sent you drinks.
Run out and get yourself a newspaper.
I know you sent me drinks. The only thing is
before 6 p.m.
Before 6 p.m. And I was so on top of things that I got nothing. I was so on top of things, I went and got 0.0.
So you get
he did
nothing.
Rescue me with my lunch, though.
Yeah.
Oh.
I was kind of busy during the day with
Steph.
Yeah,
your priorities are in line. I got it.
And also to the fact of, like, are we really going to drink really that much? I know. Listen, I would have had one. Yeah, I know.
Two. If you made a third one, I'd drink it too.
Probably a four.
Well, if you were going to make another one, I'd probably have one too.
I don't want to be rude.
No, my
day today. I don't want to be impolite, but.
Exactly. You really shouldn't be drinking.
I see it's there. Do you mind if I have it? It's okay.
I can still see one of everything, so we're good. Go ahead. We're good.
Didn't do that.
You know, they got a keg, speaking of drinking, for the wedding, and I said, you're going to regret it. You guys are going to waste so much of it. There was hardly anything left in the keg.
That's how you do it. Listen, you guys are there for 7 hours,
and
it's going to go.
Drank and drank. I believe it or not, I had wine for the toast, and that was it. I was like, what the hell is wrong with me? No, I had wine for the toast.
Oh, all right.
But other than that, I didn't have a drink that was alcoholic.
Yeah.
Ah, what a bummer. That was a bummer. But
it is what it is.
I was glad they didn't waste the keg, so then we just put it in the back of the truck and finished it off the next day.
Uh-huh. Well, I knew it was like an ongoing ice machine battle. Three freaking coolers full of ice, and this they kept on coming back for more ice. I'm thinking, you guys are going to run out of ice before the thing is
right?
Over.
And I mean, that's the only thing about the venue. I was, there was a couple things. I was disappointed in the venue, because a venue that big, if you're throwing an event like that every single weekend, you should have an ice maker. You should have a commercial ice machine. They didn't. So I had, that's why we had all those coolers of ice, because I told everyone, bring ice.
Yeah.
Because I knew we needed it for the keg, and right. I knew we were going to need it for everybody's drinks. And then I have
But you know, the thing is that is you can get ice going down that road to the end where there's a convenience store right there.
Yeah, but you shouldn't have to go back and forth. Then we,
not saying you should, but
the
I also,
catering.
Listen, I'll be honest with you. I was not that impressed with the DJ.
Okay, you said it first. Okay.
No, listen. So, when you go ahead and say, I don't know who you are, but let's go ahead and introduce you anyway. It's more parents. It's more,
right? Okay.
What the fuck is going on
it
there?
It didn't get any better from there.
Oh, God.
Like, she got the events, and she kept the actual, like, events that we needed the photographer there for, because he wasn't staying for the actual party portion of the reception. So we got all that underway and done, and it wasn't a rushed. It was done spread out pretty nicely, and gave the bride a break a little bit from the dance floor. But I could have set up my phone and done the same thing she did. There was no, like, to me, and I maybe this is just me because I DJ.
No,
you're
seen.
Supposed to keep the crowd going. Yep. You're supposed to hype them up. When the crowd was starting to die down a little bit and they kind of started mingling and shifting outside, you're supposed to do something that hypes them up, brings them back, into the dance floor and just keep the party going. There was no jokes. There was no commentary. It was just music. To play music,
when,
to play music, to
number
play
one,
music.
Who decided on that?
On the DJ?
Yeah.
After we found out you didn't have your equipment, my daughter decided to just go ahead. Because we thought with as many weddings as she's done, she would be more than capable of doing the wedding and be entertaining, we thought. And then the catering. You guys are lucky you left before the food.
Really?
Really?
I thought wasn't that smokehouse grill over
it
there next
door? It smelled real good.
It
did.
It smelled, well, okay. I thought the pork was the only thing smoked. So did David. So I guess they had chicken, and they smoked the chicken too. I ended up in an asthma attack because I took a bite of the chicken, and first bite in, I got first like chew and realized, my breath was gone. So I had my inhaler, so I was fine. But I'm like, David, the chicken is smoked too. And he goes, I didn't know. And I said, I didn't either. Then the mac and cheese, people, mac and cheese. And we even told them when we ordered the mac and cheese.
Don't
we're
smoke
talking,
the mac and cheese.
Don't do much past what you would for the box, okay? Or make a Velveeta sauce. How do you do it? We confirmed how they brought Alfredo pasta.
Hmm.
And I'm talking, it was so thick, like, it was like clay thick. And
crazy.
So I ended up having to send David's brother into town to McDonald's to get Davey something to eat. He's the only reason we ordered mac and cheese. The only reason.
That's it.
So here I have this kid can't eat. He can't stay out in that heat for all those hours and not have something to eat, because there wasn't even snacks there that he would eat, because the stuff we made for like beforehand, that's not stuff he's going to eat. So, but I went ahead and I tasted the pulled pork. First off, the pulled pork when I do my pulled pork, it's cooked and everything, but then it's smothered in the sauce. There was no seasoning on it. It was just cooked, and we were given squirt bottles to like put sauce on it.
What?
Well, we've done that before, though.
But no, that's not what you do in a catering business. Well, not in a catering. Come on now.
And it's the only thing that was edible was the dinner roll and the mashed potatoes. And I guess I did something bad. I left it, and I did apologize. But I looked at my daughter sitting at the table, and I said, $1,400, honey. I could have done so much better for half the money. Actually, probably a third of the money. But y'all didn't want me to cater it because you didn't want me to have the stressor and all that other stuff.
Which you did have a lot of stress on you, by the way.
Yes,
you
but...
did. And that would have just went... It, that would have thrown you over the top
of
the cliff.
It would have tasted so much better.
Listen, at the macaroni... I would have gotten a whole... I would have went to Sam's Club, got some big things of Velveeta mac and cheese, mm-hmm. and there you go.
Well, I get the elbow macaroni, and then I get the big blocks of Velveeta, well, and I make my own sauce.
You've made homemade mac and cheese before.
Yeah. I have, but I'm just saying, it's like, how difficult... Listen, it's like Charlie Brown trying to boil water. You mean to tell me you can't fucking do
and
that?
And then they packed it up. This was the other thing. So...
They what?
They the people that brought it out and served it.
Yeah.
Left it, I guess the food was out and everybody ate. I would say 45 minutes to an hour, and then they packed it up. Like, not put covers on it so you could go back up for another plate. Packed it and took it away.
Now, was this a buffet style?
Yes. They did dish for you. But then, yeah, that's what it was those tables there on the end that were still empty. Mm-hmm. Those got table coverings put over them and pulled out. And the servers were behind it. And, yeah, it was just the big, what do you call them? The silver tins. They got the little burners underneath them.
Yeah.
And Bunsen burners or whatever. Yeah. And that's all it was. And then.
Schaefer dishes.
Packed up. I said, who the hell packs it up? Because as you drink, you eat. Mm-hmm. And then they brought it out for us to take home probably about.
Take that shit home.
Yeah, a half hour before. Well, then we had about a half hour before we decided we were closing it up. And there was a couple they were drunk. So they went back and they got some
just
more food.
Just a couple?
Yeah. Well, I mean, a couple that actually went back for more food. I was like, y'all have at it. But I was just surprised. I was surprised that they... So those were a couple of the things that I was disappointed on that they hyped up and... It, I don't know. I just felt like it went south.
They hyped up the catering?
They hyped up the catering big time. They hyped up the DJing.
Oh, God.
And, like, I even ask.
I am so sorry. You know what? Honestly, how much was is the DJ extra? Or did DJ come with the package?
It was another $500.
$500. Honest to God, I'd use that $500. I'd go rent a system. I would have done it for free. That's how shitty
I thought
that. Can
you rent a full system?
I think you can.
Okay, be ready for December then.
All right.
I'm
well,
so
here's
disappointed.
Here's the next thing I'm going to talk to you about. And this is something me and Alyssa talked about at the wedding. And I think because of how we saw everything go down, that's what brought it to my attention. I am thinking about starting a party planning business.
See, I used to do that. I used to do wedding planning, not just party planning. But it's real big in this area, too.
But we're looking to do it like kids' parties.
Yep.
Graduation parties. Roller rink parties. Bowling parties. You know, whatever. Obviously, we would have to make some huge connections with, you know, people for equipment. Like, you know, notaries, caterers.
I can help you with people with
like
equipment.
So we're looking for wanting to bring you along. But you also have a lot on your plate because you handle... Half of you handled hall calling and contracting, and you're always so busy, and you got the kids, and it's like, we don't know. I mean, what? And you also have your own stuff you sell online.
Yeah, which I haven't been doing a lot of, in case y'all haven't noticed.
Well, yeah, it's
I've
like
you've been busy with the wedding and everything else. But I will tell you, this is what you guys need to do to start: is go with David and I because we want to go to some of the bridal.
Bridal parties.
Yeah,
shows.
The conventions and stuff like that.
Yeah.
We want to go to some of those and just. I don't know. Pick a date. Claim you're not married. I don't care. But go in there and then pick up cards. And then afterwards, now that's your connection. That's kind of your shoe-in. You've got their card. Call them, say, hey, I'm putting a network of people together for party plan, blah, blah, blah. That's how I did it.
But the one thing I want to do is I just don't want to go ahead and say, all right, I have a card, then my photographer. Because what if the photographer sucks?
No, you would have to get, like, you'd have to make sure.
Like, I liked the photographer on the wedding, during the ceremony. He was all over the place. He got different angles, different shots, different poses. I'm very surprised to hear that, oh, he's not going to stay for the entire party.
It costs more time, and Tori figured during the party end of it, everybody's out with their phones anyway.
Okay, so it was basically a money situation.
Well, and it was a convenience too, because my son's wife does photography.
Right.
She had a professional camera. A friend of ours, the bridesmaid's mom, she had a camera, although she was annoying the shit out of us. And then actually Davey came up to me and he goes, Mom, hide me from that woman. I can't take anymore. I'm like, okay, I got you. We had several other photographers that could take care of the reception. And I don't mean the cake cutting. He stayed for the cake cutting, stuff like that.
What weirded me out is that you had, okay, fine, we have the introductions. No toasts, no dinner, which I
yeah, the toast didn't happen until after dinner.
But yeah, so Alyssa was right on that one. I'm over here expecting, well, how it normally goes is, you have the ceremony, which was early, I get it. You have the ceremony, you have an hour of pictures, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock comes along, you have everybody sit down, dinner should be, you know, ready to go.
Yeah.
But they did the events, they did garter and bouquet toss.
Yeah.
They did the cake cutting, and that's like, no, you're not. That's not really how it's supposed to go, unless it is specified with the bride and groom that
she had to have. I don't know for sure that she did, but I'm just assuming that she did because of the photographer. So
here's how it goes in normal cases: ceremony, you have an hour of hors d'oeuvres,
right?
Everybody's introduced. Usually, first dance happens there. There's a 50-50 split on people wanting to do first dance either before dinner or after dinner.
Right.
Then you have toast, blessing, dinner. Then you have a little bit of dancing. Then you bring out garter and bouquet. A little more dancing. And at the point in time where it's an hour at the end, hour, you give yourself 1 hour before the end of the whole thing, cake cutting.
Right.
Have cake cutting. Do that little thing. Another round of dancing.
Yeah, because that's your dessert. So right. You've already had dinner and everything, and then the cake is just your dessert. Because a lot of people didn't even have, and that was another thing. They were supposed to have somebody there to serve the cake after they cut it. There was no one.
And it was just so dry.
There was no one. Oh
just
my God,
so
the
dry
cake.
The way she presented the, as being a DJ.
Yes.
It's like, oh, we're going to be there. I mean, listen, granted, it's country. Granted, we know it wasn't a wedding.
Right.
It was a wedding.
Right.
It was really nicely and dressed up. So it's like three times she's going ahead and say, all right, now the maid of honor and best man. And it's like parents. Oh, you're the parents. I don't know your names, but come on
and
let's go.
Went
let's
over, and we went over the parents as well beforehand. Yeah. And
it's like,
as a matter of fact, I was there twice that we went over the parents that were going to be listed.
And on top of that, too, I'm over here sitting down waiting for the ceremony to begin. No music.
Nothing.
Why?
That was so... And I'm thinking to myself, she remembers she's supposed to play music for this. Tori will absolutely have a shit fit if the music isn't played for her to enter.
Well,
and I was also disappointed that her husband, who's got to stand there in front of everybody, was in shorts and a t-shirt. You would think, I mean...
I was kind of wondering about that, too. I thought he was a construction guy or something.
Yeah, I was thinking you would
like, who the
think
fuck
that
is
he would
guy?
At least be dressed for this portion.
Right.
I'm not saying tux or anything,
no.
But at least dress up a little bit. You're
like
standing in front of
nice
every-
shirt.
Listen,
you know.
I came in what I thought was bare bones minimum, and I apologize, but bare bones minimum, I was like, I was in a nice set of jeans and a polo.
And I that's what
you
I
didn't
expected
didn't even have a tie or a
in.
Button down.
No, none of it. And it wasn't because... so many of the guys hate the ties anyway, but although we're doing ties for our wedding, but I expected him to be in at least jeans, even if he was in the t-shirt, that would have been fine.
Wait a minute,
at least
wait a minute.
Put
when
a pair
in,
of jeans on.
When in November?
December.
Oh, December. Okay, good.
December 18th.
But I'm saying, if it's that one weekend in November, it ain't happening. Just letting you know. We got our own, you know, celebration to deal with.
Well, we've got our own, and then we've got Stefan's Gotcha Days a week later.
Yep. Yep. So November is like,
Nope, it's December.
And then Thanksgiving. And then...
I know your November is as packed. Busy as our like December, January.
Well, our Gotcha Day is kind of coinciding with the same week as Thanksgiving anyway, so it's like we can really knock those 2 weekends out. Usually it's our anniversary, which here, let me now it's December of this year or next year?
This year.
So like so, right now November 16th, which is our anniversary day, falls on a Tuesday. Gotcha Day falls on a Monday. So it's like those 2 weekends you can go. I can do the 20 and then, yeah.
Right.
That's, same week. So, 13th and 14th, 20th and 21st, 27th and 28th. Just cancel that out for Christmas.
It's busy. Yeah. And that's the only thing about December that I am kind of dreading.
Are you going to do 12, 12, 21? Because that's a Sunday.
No, I'm doing 12, 18.
Oh, okay. That was the next Saturday. Okay.
And I can't remember why we decided on 18.
I don't know. Some legal age, maybe?
I don't know.
You could do 12, 12.
12, 12. That's what I just said.
You said it's a Sunday. Oh, maybe that's why. We wanted a day. We wanted Saturday because we wanted nobody to have to be to work the next day.
It's called taking a vacation day.
Oh, my gosh.
What's going on over there?
Are they
calling you?
This actually leads us. Oh, I thought I could leave a message, but apparently I can't.
Who's
calling? I could send him a message.
David?
No, a friend of ours, but...
All right, never mind. Because I'll call him right on now on the air. We get this. You say, hey, listen, you're bothering my co-host.
He's probably got some type of job, but this is actually what I was going to tell you about David. Is David today, I actually took him for lunch and told him, I said, you have got to calm down, have a beer. Because
why?
He was so wound up because business is picking up, and he'll be on one job. And 5 more calls are coming in. And I said, this is a great thing, but it's not great for David to try and manage.
I think he might need to go ahead and hire some help.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
And told him I'd call David. But I told him, I said, he goes, well, it's all just coming at me at one time. I said, I understand that. And I said, that's a good thing. I said, just be happy about it. Take a deep breath and chill. It'll all get done.
By the way, if you want to stress out David any further, Hulk calling and contracting. Lawn jobs, car jobs, house jobs, blow jobs, you name it, he does it. 941-204-1264. And Karen doesn't do the blow job thing, but 941-916-0130, unless you pay her a little extra, I guess. But that's Hulk Hulling and Contracting. Make sure you go ahead and give them a call. They serve all of South Florida. So.
Yes, we do.
But yeah, party planning, I'm telling you, I'm really thinking of that. I'm really looking into it because... And a big motivation is like, I take a look at my cousin and how he's built his own empire, sort of empire, but he's built his own thing on what he knows.
Right.
His contracting, you know, building houses, construction. And I'm over here thinking, say, well, what the hell do I know? I don't know anything. Oh, yeah, I know DJing.
Right.
I know how, you know, weddings go. I mean, partying, maybe I can learn a little something here. But, you know, I'm over here thinking, it's like, saying a bad idea. Well, how much do party planners make? It's like I see him somewhere between $500 and $900 an event,
mm-hmm.
depending on, you know, what the size of the event is and what the
and
area
how much you're
is,
planning
yeah.
of it too. Yeah.
So I'm over here thinking it's like maybe we can go mm-hmm. ahead and start our own business and work and not have to worry about punching a time clock for anybody else.
Well, and especially if. I mean, you guys are going to do this together. It makes it even better.
That's the thing is, too. It's like I would even come out of DJ retirement, get my own setup back up again.
Right.
I'll make that part of it. I don't know about the catering. Catering, I think, is going to take a lot. But I can offer like a limited menu of what I do know.
Either that or, I mean, you can also, when you do your party planning, instead of you doing everything... You could build yourself a network of people that do other jobs.
Well, that's what I was planning on doing anyway. But it's like, you know, if you want to go ahead, instead of going ahead and networking, I mean, I'm still network DJs, you know, other
right.
DJs that don't, you know, that have more experience than I do. I'd be like the bottom end DJ. Listen, if you want to go ahead and do the bare bones package, I'll go ahead and
right.
play a few songs and make a few announcements and stuff like that, which will still be, it's still going to be par to what a normal wedding DJ would be.
Right.
Because I get up there, I'm pretty entertaining.
Well, I gave, like, if they were to use, if they used my makeup and hair person or my caterer
right.
that I had references for, then they got 10% off of their, whatever they hired them for. So,
but
and that
is,
helps
this
too.
This is something I wanted to bring you in as a conversation to see if you wanted a piece of the pie on this and see if you would either join the team or have input on the team or whatever. But again,
I'll
like I said, I
help you.
I definitely know that your hands are kind of tied with everything going on. And I don't want you overexerting yourself.
The slower it gets, the more depressed I get. No, I think I do handle chaos better than downtime. But
well, I want to make sure
now that the wedding's
is...
out of the way, David's dad, he goes tomorrow. We're pretty sure he's still cancer free.
Okay, good.
So
good.
I don't have weekly appointments there. So that frees up some extra time. And now that David's getting busier, I'm not scouting for work as much for him as I once was either. So that kind of helps. I think it'd be great for you guys. I think you'd be good at it. She's definitely got a good head on her shoulders when it comes to putting things together too. So, and that helps with weddings because they're always, no matter what they have in their head, they're always going to ask your opinion. Like, well, what do you think of this? Well, this is what I'm thinking. And if you, go to these, bridal shows and stuff, you're going to pick up more people and you're going to know who's out there and who
yep.
you can recommend and so on and so forth. So,
and it's like, that's what we'd be doing. And again, I'm very new into party planning businesses. Like really, like, what do they really want to come to me for? Can't they do this on their own? And it's like, well, the more we handle, the more they trust us, you know, and that's where it's going to be hard because they want somebody with a reputation.
Right.
That's going to be the difficult part.
You've done DJing for wedding and stuff like that before, though.
I get that, but that doesn't necessarily qualify me to go ahead and be a responsible party planner. That's where I'm going to be hitting the pavement a little bit hard. That's where I may come to you and like say, hey, you've gotten more experience on it, and I can add you to the team.
I think, too, that's where I think Alyssa's going to be an asset because she can make those follow-up calls and those arrangement calls and that have to be made. Like I told Tori the week before her wedding, I said, you need to call everyone that you've hired mm-hmm. and verify every detail for your day. Oh, no, we've already paid our, you know, everything's completely paid and everything's arranged. I said, no, Tori, things happen. Papers for orders and arrangements get hidden, dropped, thrown away. You verify the week before so you don't have some disaster happen the day of. And that's the nice thing about having a party planner is because the planner's who does that for you and then reiterates those things to you. And I think the little bit I've seen her do with paperwork, with work and stuff for school and stuff,
mm-hmm.
she'd be good at keeping that organized and everything. And as long as you have that and then you know where you have to be when you have to be there, I mean, you should be good to go. I think it's right up your alley.
Well, I think so, too. I think that's going to be something we can definitely go ahead and knock out. It's going to take some time to do it, though.
Oh, yeah.
But, all right. So we got memes coming up. Memes.
We do.
We got good news. And we got a few stories here, a couple of them having to deal with St. Patrick's Day. We keep forgetting today is St. Patrick's Day. We had a little corned beef and cabbage today. First time I've ever delved into that recipe. So far, it's been a big hit. So appreciate that. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to take a break right now. Come on back. We've got the memes, good news, a couple of stories. A lot more entertaining than Tom Gully's show. That's a damn sure. Actually, speaking of his show, let's see what he's up to. Right now.
For $17.5 million from Wayne Gretzky, lost it to Fort Cliff.
That's right. He's still on the same thing there. With this.
Car. The day after, he'd been charged with embezzling from a bankruptcy estate. Uh-oh. Here we go.
Here we go. Yep. our break. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. We'll stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Be kind and rewind. The Charles Richardson Show will be right back.
Liar. My friends all say you've been fooling around. shit, there it is. A glory hole right next to the settling cracks and the door dings. This calls for your secret weapon. You break out the marshmallow paste, but it's not shutting down that hole. The penises are still flying in. Hey there, I'm Bo Riles, glory hole virtuoso. If you're trying to shut down operations on a glory hole, look no further than the liquid drywall. Just spray our whipped cream on there and bingo bango bongo vanishes in seconds. The portal to the dick dimension may be closed, but those cherished memories of sucked wieners will live on within you forever. Our shaving cream requires no extra tools, no mess, no repairmen. Fuck this repair guy in particular. Give me that wall, bitch. Let me show you how the liquid drywall works. It takes that wall and it puts it in a can. This is wall in a can, motherfucker. It doesn't get more simple than that. Then you spray it on the wall and that wall leaves the can. Now that wall's on your wall. Gone are the days of playing with old Play-Doh. Gone are the days of painting cake frosting on your walls. Martha, you clumsy slut, you've banged the table into the wall. But luckily, thanks to the liquid drywall, we don't have to sell the house anymore. Thanks to the fast and easy repairs. Whoopsie, you got a little asshole on your wall? Butt plugged. No problem. I'm filling more holes than a male porn star today. Another one hiding behind the door? Not on my watch. What's that smell? Another one? Oh, goodness me, more holes than a block of cheese in this motherfucker. But luckily, there's no match for the liquid drywall. If your house is prone to glory holes, go ahead and install our boner barricade with the liquid drywall. No more worrying about rogue cocks popping in. Are your kids so dumb they fight over the broom and then hit the wall? Well, we can fix the wall, but we can't fix the bad parenting that led to this situation in the first place. There's billions of people on this planet. That's a lot of penises. Liquid drywall.
We're back to the best show you have never heard of. That's the Charles Richardson Show.
Not going to go ahead and lie, the microphone's kind of off mute at that time for the Facebook Live people, so I apologize about that. we're listening to some pretty nasty lesbian stories from Alyssa and Karen, so paying no attention to those, that doesn't really happen.
Sorry to all the bad people we said things about.
Yep. yeah. So, anyway, 813-699-5353. Let's go right into the memes. And let's see what we got over here. Desktop, display, here we go. We don't want that, we want the second display. And of course, I like how that works. Add new layer, add display. Apologize, folks. There we go. We'll go ahead and make this a little bit bigger. All right. So here's what we got here. This is Yoda peeking out there from a bowl. When people say, quote, she really is nice once you get to know her, may as well say she's a bitch, but you'll get used to it. I guess we shouldn't call it the White House because that's racist. We'll call it the Nut House. I can't raise my legs for shit during a workout, but when it's time to fuck them motherfuckers, be like, hi-ya! Tomorrow isn't promised. Cuss them out today.
I think so.
Yeah. $1,400 per child. Hold up, Maury. Maybe that baby does kind of look like me.
No,
no,
I sent you like
more.
9 or 10 of
them. But wait,
like
there's
more.
What the fuck? Let's try this here. Oh man, it's.
What did you do?
I don't know. Lead me not into temptation. Oh, who the fuck am I kidding? Follow me. I know a shortcut. Oh, I know why.
Said all my kids.
Stupid people act like glow sticks. I want to snap them and shake the shit out of them till the light comes on.
Yes. Yes, I do.
Coffee spelled backwards is E-E-F-F-O-C. Just know that I don't give a E-fuck until I've had my coffee.
Sorry, I know you love Aladdin.
Yeah, Aladdin taught me that good things happen to those who rub one out.
That was from last time.
All right, so
figured that out. This one here is from Alyssa. 69 today. Love you, Mom. And the comment there says, I really hope it's her birthday.
Oh, true.
This one here is a cartoon of a judge throwing the book at somebody. For your heinous crimes, I sentence you to a slap on the wrist. Say, whew. Bring in the slapper. And it comes out with this big guy with a really big arm, big arms. Okay, this has a picture of the off can for flies, where they fly literally with his beak stuck in the little centered part where the spray comes out. Them, if you don't stop putting toxins in your body, it'll kill you. And then me goes with the fly in the picture. There's Shaquille O'Neal reading the book. Me realizing I could start calling people who don't want to have sex with me ugly phobic.
Oh, jeez.
That's wrong. Here's one here with a missile with a cartoon character. It looks like Rick. Imagine the last thing you'll ever see before you die is Missile Rick!
Oh, jeez.
I just found my favorite Japanese word, Kushi Sabayashi. When you're not hungry, but you eat because your mouth is lonely.
Oh.
I think I even mispronounced it. Here's Winnie the Pooh on the left side. Just a real downer right there on the top one. It says boner. The one is a little bit, worked up there. It says morning wood. And then he looks like the freaking Monopoly guy where the store says sunrise meats. And that's all she wrote for that one. Get all of it?
I think I did. We got all of it.
Yeah, we got all of it. All right, there's your memes for today, St. Patrick's Day, March the 17th, 2021, right here on the Charles
Richardson
Show.
And none of them were Irish.
None of them were. You know what? It doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter. Because honestly, even people that are Irish really don't give a shit.
No.
I mean, honestly, it really
doesn't.
It's
just an excuse for people to wear green and drink,
and
green
and
beer.
Do we have any good news, by the way?
Yeah.
We do. Okay, so let's go ahead and get... Oh, man, I really want to get through these stories, but we only got like 10 minutes, and I don't know how long that news story is.
Not probably that long.
Disneyland officially will open April 30th, not April Fool's Day. According to Disneyland in California, they're going to be opening with limited capacity. Of course, being closed for more than a year because of the coronavirus, the entertainment said that they will open now. The entertainment giant said April 30th. The theme parks initially will admit only California residents while Disney continues to follow state and health safety protocols. Californians interested in visiting the parks will have to use a new reservation system, which we already know about that, with Disney yet to release booking details. Attractions that draw large crowds, such as parades, nighttime fireworks, they will be remaining on hiatus. Some hotels around Disneyland will reopen with limited capacity on April 29th. Disney plans to reopen the Grand Floridian Hotel and Spa on May 2nd and the Paradise Pier Hotel later on in the year. They hope to welcome guests and customers back to their parks in last July, but had to, of course, reverse course. We're excited to have more than 10,000 cast members returning to work as we get ready to welcome our guests back to this happy place.
Woohoo!
Yep.
Yeah,
so
they gotta, get rid of all the cobwebs and,
Yeah.
Ready to go.
You know, you would think, though, that they've been having the janitorial staff just keep maintaining things because
I'm sure
there.
They have.
Yeah.
Because didn't they also use it as
a vaccination site?
A vaccination
Well, the parking
facility?
Lot. I don't know that they...
But I'm sure they kept everything in tip-top shape inside the park.
Did you also see that they scientifically proved that ride that you guys, something mountain, what'd you guys ride this weekend?
Which
we
one?
Didn't ride any mountain.
No, okay. What's the two rides? Slinky Dog and
Slinky
what was
Dog
one?
And Mine Train.
Mine Train.
What was the?
I think it was Mine
down?
Train, but they scientifically proved that it helps pass kidney stones.
Oh yeah. The I saw that. That's something we'll cover on Friday.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm curious. Which ride is it?
Any roller coaster, actually.
Oh.
Roller coasters help pass kidney stones.
Interesting.
bill in the Florida Senate banning transgender athletes from female competitions is now passing its first hurdle and first kidney stone. A bill seeking to ban a bill seeking to ban transgender athletes after completing advocates for the transgender community came out in force to oppose what they consider a discriminatory piece of legislation. No, it's discriminatory, and it's being taken advantage of for people that want to change their own sex. Florida is one of 25 states considering legislation that would ban transgender athletes from competing in women-only leagues. So that's great news.
Mm-hmm.
A Republican, Tuck, who is a Republican from Highlands County, is the bill's sponsor. She says the bill's support about fairness. Nearly 50 years after Title IX, all gains women that they've made athletically would be wiped away. The Fairness in Women's Sports Act is intended to make sure that doesn't happen. But in the bill's first hearing, parents of trans children said the legislation feels like discrimination. Don't have your kids go to fucking female then. That's all I can say.
Yep.
Any comment on that real quick? No?
No. 100% agree.
Good. FDA warns not to drink company bottled water after several people had liver damage and diarrhea. According to this here, Real Water's alkaline water is the one that you need to stay away from. The FDA became involved when it was alerted to 5 cases of acute non-viral hepatitis resulting in acute liver failure in infants and young children that occurred in November 2020 in Southern Nevada Health District. Wow, November 2020, and we're already in March.
Right?
Great. That's fantastic. I wonder how many other people are going to die.
Nice, timely fashion on that release.
Dumb shit. The consumption of Real Water brand is the only common link identified between all of these cases to date. The FDA regulates bottled water under the Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act. Really? Cosmetic? I really hope I read that wrong, and I hope
cosmetics
misspoke.
Are edible these days.
I guess so. Just ask people that down Tide Pods. And finally, a woman attacks Popeye's worker, steals money from register through the drive-thru, but apparently she did not like Popeye's. Palm Beach County detectives were searching for 4 women involved in a dramatic robbery at a Popeye's restaurant near Latina in Florida on Tuesday. The crime happened around 1:15 p.m. at the restaurant located on Seacrest Boulevard, not to be confused with Ryan Seacrest. The Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office said a silver Nissan Sentra pulled up to the drive-thru, and a woman inside the car got into a verbal argument with the cashier. Apparently, she wanted a spicy chicken sandwich, not the regular. Then she went ahead and spit on and attacked the worker. Two other women got out of the car and began attacking other employees inside the restaurant. It became a full-on brawl.
What the hell?
Palm Beach Sheriff's Office said one of the women reached into the drive-thru window and grabbed money from the cash register. The 4 women then took off in the Sentra. If you know anything about, call 1-800-458-TIPS.
Take some spicy mayonnaise, squirt it on the sandwich, and there you go.
Listen,
you
there's a lot of things.
Spicy chicken sandwich.
There's a lot of things spicy about that, and we're just not going to go there.
What?
Let's go ahead and get to the news here, since we only got like 4 minutes to go, and one of them is probably going to be eat up by the music that I have to play, or I always play. Play it, damn it. Thank you. Let's go to our Big Boob reporter.
Right on time.
A California town gave struggling folks free money for a year.
Free money?
Yeah. In an encouraging flip of the narrative, an experiment demonstrated that basic income recipients in a California city showed intelligence and ambition, not lethargy. The randomized controlled trial in the city of Stockton is being viewed by sociologists as a good jumping off point for further research into the effects of a no strings attached cash injection to alleviate the difficulties of living in the lower income class. The project was called SEED, Stockton Economic Empowerment Demonstration. I cannot read.
It's okay.
And it took place from February 2018 to February 2020, distributing $500 every month for 2 years to 125 people living around or below the city's median household income, resulted in participants acquisitioning of full-time jobs climbing up to 200% above a control group of participants who did not receive income. The jump was still less than what is seen in traditional unemployment benefits, though those receiving the $500 were not necessarily unemployed.
Right.
Unlike unemployment benefits, though, participants were not told their reception of the money would hinge on their searching for a job. Instead, they received their money on a debit card and were told to spend it on whatever they liked.
Cool.
The vast majority of the spending was on things one might imagine it would go towards, such as food, utilities, rent, auto maintenance, and so on. Another significant finding was that it allowed participants in a little more allowed participants a little more time in the day to enjoy life, spend time with their families, or study to potentially improve their skill sets.
Right.
The $500 spilled into their extended networks in material and immaterial ways and alleviated financial strain across fragile networks and gathered more time for relationships, the authors wrote. One man had spent an entire year being eligible to receive a real estate license, but never actually had time to begin the process. The $500 allowed him to take time off work and get his certificate and switch careers, resulting in a 360-degree turn around of his fortunes. So yeah, they gave people free money, and they were actually able to improve themselves because of it.
But you see, the thing is, though, when you go ahead and get free money to people that actually need it versus we're going to get free money to people that don't really need it,
they can go ahead and get off their ass and make it and get a job. That's two different things right there. So,
well,
but this one here helped out. This actually was a
experiment. It was an experiment to see what would happen if you gave people who were working, who were trying, but just needed a little bit more.
Right.
Some more, and, you know, and it ends up that they
They
took that boost and they were able to achieve more because of it.
Those are the smart people. Those are the type of people that if they get the $400 stimulus, they're going to do good with it. That's all the time we got, everybody. Happy Wednesday. Be safe out there. Enjoy the time change because it gets darker later now. But we'll see you on Friday, hopefully for a funner it'll be a fun show. Don't worry about it. Actually, let's go ahead and check in on Tom Gully's show real quick here. Let's see how he's doing.
So there you are. There you go.
There you are. There you go. More silence.
Internet things are just really.
I don't know.
We're out of here, folks.
Just.
Oh,
yeah.
That's so perfect.
Take care, everybody.